Thank you. Graduands, guests and colleagues, my name is Mary Howarth and I'm delighted to welcome you all to graduation. I have a few announcements to make before we begin so that you can relax and enjoy the ceremony. Graduands, an easy job to start with. Please check that your seat number matches the number on your ticket because you'll be called to the stage in this order. If you discover that these do not match, our team of stewards can help you locate the correct seat. At the appropriate time, you'll be invited by the stewards to stand and to make your way to the foot of the stairs, ready to head up the stairs and across the stage. All very straightforward. There are two key things which make for a seamless ceremony. Firstly, as soon as the person ahead of you begins to cross the stage, please make sure you make your way up the stairs. Please don't wait until they've passed across the stage before you reach the top of the stairs. Secondly, don't let excitement and pride overwhelm you so much that you forget to pick up your degree parchment after you've crossed the stage. If you do, don't worry, you have still graduated. But don't try to go back because you will collide with someone coming the other way. Instead, please visit the graduation information desk in the Spring Lane building 30 minutes after the ceremony to collect your parchment. At the end of the ceremony, graduates are asked to process out of the hall directed by the stewards. Family and friends, the stewards will show you to the exits once the graduates have left the hall. If the fire alarm should sound at any point, please remain in your seats. Instructions will be given and we'll escort you to the nearest exit. As graduates, you will join an international community of over 130,000 alumni in 183 countries. York's Global Alumni Association organizes events and networks and services designed to help you make connections with other alumni across the world and to support your career prospects. So please visit the Alumni Association stand and photo booth in the Spring Lane building where you can pick up your graduation gift to welcome you into the association. As you get your first job or take up further study or training, please remember to keep us in touch with what you're doing. Understanding the career paths that you take will help us provide the right information for current students and make sure we offer graduates like you the best information and opportunities that we can. Finally, please turn your mobile phones to silent, and will you all now please stand?
Good afternoon. On this rather damp Yorkshire day, it's a great pleasure to welcome you to our beautiful campus. Please be seated. I now declare the congregation open for the conferment of awards. So again, good afternoon and welcome to this very exciting day, which is a special milestone in your lives. This is also a wonderful time of the year for everyone who works in the university. It's really inspiring to see so many happy and proud people here today. I want to offer you my warmest and most sincere congratulations. Gaining your degree from a world-class university like York is a tremendous achievement. It shows just how much you have devoted your best efforts to your studies. The university is enormously proud of you, as are your families, your partners and friends, and indeed everyone else who has supported you through your time here. When you made the decision to come to the university, you made a choice that's likely to have a lasting effect on your life. As I'm sure you know, there are many reasons why people decide to go to university. Perhaps you came to York because you wanted to prepare for a career in a chosen field, or to improve your employment prospect. Perhaps you came because you were passionate about your subject, or perhaps you simply came because you wanted to leave home. Whatever the reasons, we hope you've achieved your personal aims and ambitions. In very recent years, the public discourse around higher education has revolved around universities as drivers of economic growth, relevant for today, and also the role of higher education in delivering a productive workforce. Whereas such constructs are undoubtedly important, we shouldn't lose sight of the much wider relevance of higher education for society. Education is a common good that benefits us all in ways that may be difficult to measure, but are still no less important. Education enables societies to work together, to build together, and to live peacefully together. Education protects us from extremism, intolerance, and prejudice. Fundamentally, education makes us all better people. And I hope that you use your newfound skills to the benefit of people and society. I hope that you've had a great time here at the university, which I'm sure was not all spent on hard work and intellectual contemplation. I've seen and heard you having a wonderful time in your colleges and indeed in the city. I am, of course, also aware of what goes on through social media. Unfortunately, Instagram holds few secrets. And you know what all of this says about you? It shows that you are, on the whole, a lively, sociable, and caring group of people with a great zest for life. And so it should be. Being at university is about much more than just study and work. During your time with us, you will have met people who will hopefully remain friends for the rest of your life. You will have joined student societies or explored new interests. You will have experienced life in a community that is diverse and truly international. I think you will find that these experiences have been just as valuable as any formal learning in shaping who you are and what you can become. Since 1963, when the university was founded, we've inspired over 130,000 people to cross both this platform and continents and to embrace almost every imaginable job and profession. And now it's your turn to go out and explore new horizons. As graduates, you will be part of our worldwide community of alumni, with members from 183 countries across the world. Our global A to Z directory extends from Afghanistan to Zimbabwe. and I hope that you'll be able to join us at events across the globe and support many of our important activities. Whether joining a professional network or volunteering time as an online mentor, there is a reason for everyone to remain involved with our university community. A community that still absolutely adheres to the founding principles of excellence, equality, and opportunity for all. One key element of our work is philanthropy, where we come together to support areas such as scholarships, which open the doors to education for students who've overcome immense difficulty to be here. That's why a key theme of our York Unlimited philanthropy campaign is raising money to enable every student to shine, so that anyone who can benefit from a York education has the opportunity to do so. I do know that many of you have already raised funds to support the next generation of students. You have played a vital role in ensuring that your successors will benefit from scholarship provision. So a big thank you to you all. It's a tradition that speeches at graduation ceremonies close by offering much well-intended advice to inspire you as graduates. Well, actually, I'm not sure you particularly need my advice, but there are some things that probably matter more than anything else. First, try to be kind and compassionate to other people, because kindness and compassion underpins civil society. Second, never forget that the world is a very interesting place. Never stop questioning and trying to understand it better. Third, make sure you enjoy whatever you do, but have the courage to change direction if you don't. And finally, be lucky. But remember that Louis Pasteur said that chance favours only the prepared mind. So, for now, I wish you all well. Make us proud, and above all, always strive to be the best that you can be. And being York graduates, I'm sure you'll have a great time along the way. So many congratulations, and good luck for your future. Thank you.
The Chancellor's Leadership Prizes recognise and reward the most talented, ambitious, and committed students who have excelled in the final stage of the University's York Award. In this ceremony, a Chancellor's Leadership Prize is being awarded to Naomi Karthigesu from the School of Philosophy, Politics, and Economics.
Vice-Chancellor, I have the honour to present the following candidates for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Economics. For research in terms of trade neutrality to exchange rate shifts, Eustace Dynalkas. For research in macroprudential policies and immigration studies, Ida Garcia Larrazo. For research in the term structure of Treasury and corporate yields, Leisha Lee. For research on parental inputs and child development, Gloria Moroni. for research and essays on the political economy of development, Jahen Rezki. For research in How Do People Choose, Nutapawn Roshana Hastin. For research in explaining variation in quality across GP practice, Risa Financial Dos Santos. For research in asset pricing and investment puzzle in the UK, Donga Jung. For the degree of Master of Science in Finance, Zhao Dang Zhao. For the degree of Master of Philosophy in Economics, Xiao Ji Liu. For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Economics, Ayoji Aroliai. Sophie Ashcroft. Catherine Bull. Ella Barker. Valentina Bellani. Maya Biswas Gladwin. Robert Bolton. Richard Borlin. Imogen Bowes. Michael Boys. Lucy Brooks. Jack Brownson. Fraser Bryden. John Carhill. Bradley Cohn. David Cole. Brian Conway. Benjamin Corner. Joseph Coupland. James Delahunty. Paige Delaney. Isabella Drobeck. Robert Dykes. Lauren Eagles. Robert Farrell. James Fitzgibbons. Sohini Goswami. Jasmine Gottabed. Pierre Goulin. Daniel Graves. Grace Hales. Kieran Hamilton. Oliver Harris. Gregory Hartnett. James Haslam. Nicholas Hatcher. Brian Henry. India Hewitt. Jacob Hill. Joel Hind. Jack Horsey. Emma Howard. Esther Idukula. Harriet Jeans. Nicholas Jones. Syed Cartham. Eve Kemp. Stephen Kerslake. Devon Keshvala. Theo Kinnersley. Arabella Kirby. Kisong Kugathasan. Joyce Cup. Alice Lane. Thomas Ledson. Taryn Lidder. Dylan Masuria. Michael Maley. Rosita Mastricci. Sara Morgi. Rory McGregor. Daniel McCarty. Anish Mehta. Philippa Mary. Brandon Mangomi. Elliot Morton. Holly Neal. Harry Norman. Hafiz Oyeniyan. Fergus Piper. James Price. Hiza Ramzan. Matthew Ray. Krithika Sivrajan. Ayeshwariya Sejal. Monil Shah. AUC Sharma. Akshay Soni. Alexandra Sturton. Nicholas Taylor. Kiran Uthamchanfani. Adam Valley. Hannah Waite. Nancy Lan Wong. Theo Weir. Max Whittaker. Alice Victoria Wilkinson. Jamie Wilson. Natalie Wong. Thomas Walcott. Jennifer Dew. For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Economics and Econometrics, Della Amen Yenu. Norman Bukowski. Ngozi Emenki. Tobias Firth. Nienki Lijenka. Jack Lizamore. Henry Lynch. Yanina Opan Asenko. Michael Roberts. Bachelor of Science in Economics and Finance, Hao Ai. Ayman Al-Omashi. Azaye Batbaya. Edward Bottomley. Victoria Brimble. Daniel Bush. Sam Carlton. Cameron Carr. Olivia Charnley. George Cornish. Georgia Davis. Georgina Dracy. Xiao Yong Duan Mu. Christopher Elliott. Joseph Gallagher. Charles Gray. Lucas Grodziki. Michael Herbert. Jack Hopkinson. Andrew Jones. Tian Sir Lee. Joseph McQueenie. Jack Newton. Charlotte Perk. Eftalia Passia. Daniel Taylor. Thomas Turner. Rose Wittenberg. Yiming Wu. For the degree of Bachelor of Science, Ordinary in Economics, Econometrics and Finance, Hubert Galdowski. For the degree of Bachelor of Science, Ordinary in Economics, Daniel Obaro. Vice-Chancellor, I have the honour to present the following candidate for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Psychology and Education, Sarah Kouroudoudis Patterson. Vice-Chancellor, I have the honour to present the following candidate for the degree of Master of Arts in Social Research, Zeng Uli.
Ladies and gentlemen, ensemble Anonimi will perform Here Comes the Sun by the Beatles, followed by Run to You by Pentatonix.
Here comes the sun.
Here comes the sun.
Here comes the sun.
Here comes the sun.
Little darling. It's been a long, cold, lonely winter. Little darling, it seems like years since it's been here.
Here comes the sun, and I say,
here comes the sun,
and I say, it's all right.
Little
darling, the smiles return into their faces.
Here comes the sun.
Little darling, the sun. It seems like years since it's been here.
Since it's been here.
Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun. And I say, it's all right.
Since it's been clear.
Here comes the sun, here comes the sun,
here comes the sun,
and I say, it's all right. Here comes the sun, and I say,
here comes the sun,
and I say, it's all right. It's all right.
Sun comes the sun,
all right. tried, it was true, as your glance met my stare, but your heart drifted off like the lamps dip by sea. I tried to go, to follow, to kneel down at your feet. I'll run, I'll run, I'll run, run to you.
Vice-Chancellor, I have the honour to present the following candidates for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Philosophy, Politics and Economics, for research in World Bank Multi-Pillar Pension System in Thailand. Pontip Smith Sarakan. For the degree of Masters of Arts in Philosophy, Politics and Economics, Philosophy and Public Affairs, Max Flem. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Economics and Philosophy, Luke Burgeon. Samuel French. Aaron Hassan. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Economics and Politics, Matthew Connell. Mayiri Galbraith. Catherine Hill. Ellen Kelly. Edwards Lines. Tim Nguyen. Alexander Partridge. Kava Ramadan. Jesse Saunders. Apira Sivana Sakaja. For the degree of Bachelor in Arts in Philosophy and Politics, Emily Bradshaw. William Blanchard Fenn. Daniel Brooks. Jacob Brownie. Charles Bruce. Hugo Catman. Roberta Dennis. Kathleen Falconer. Sasha Jill. Louise Gregory. Kitty Ive. Alicia Lai. Jay Lister. Ilsa McGregor. Lara Mundy. Abraham Reeve. Javun Rohila. Rowan Whitehead. Oliver Whittam. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Philosophy, Politics and Economics, Danielle Ayakaya. Muhammad Hussein Ali. Amy Alsop. Alexander Angwin. Nina Amangai. Edwin Barnes. Charlotte Barnett. Barrett. John Barton. Nikolaos Belegris. Joshua Brown. Alexander Buck. Katie Butcher. Shukran Agam Khan. Frank Simon Davis. Simran Desi. Gaya Dillon. Kaisar Denison. Peter Dalsett. Aidan Duffy. Peter Dunlop. Andrew Dunn. Neil Dutts. Flora Gair. Charlie Gardner. Lydia Giesen. David Gray. James Griffiths. Malde Gronert. Jivan Gupta. Baidya Hameen Mustafa. Clarice Harper Smith. Max Ashby Horn. Annabel Halston. Rory Hutchison. Isabel Jackson. Alice Jones. Naomi Katigesu. Finn Carvey. George Keeline. Wilhelm Kervelin. Charlotte Lee. Harris Lloyd. Mackenzie Matlett. Satanara Manoharan. Isabel May. Clara McCarthy. Eleanor Meddings Richardson. Sayira Mela. Babil Nobi Burr. Favour Olakide. James Bactert. Vanui Paisa Pepin. Andrew Penny. Georgia Pirego. Finn Pierrot. Edwards Robbins. Clytrine Robertson. Bavreen Sandhu. Naomi Sargent. Tyra Silandula. Edmund Stutter. Yakovos Sakilogolou. Albert Ward. Naomi Williams. Oliver Wilson. Theodore Wilson. Christopher Wyatt. And Benjamin Yokyan Zoega.
It's my enormous pleasure to introduce Shahbaz Ahmad, a student orator who will speak on behalf of the class of 2019. Our student orators have been invited to speak in recognition of their hard work on behalf of the student community and commitment to their studies. Our speakers have both pursued the most enriching experience they could during their time at York, as well as giving back to their community. On behalf of the class of 2019, I give you Shahbaz Ahmad.
Thank you for that warm welcome and for this incredible honour. Today is a great day. Today is a day for great celebration. Today, all of our hard work over these past few years is recognised. The countless productive hours spent in the library and the one too many hours spent outside it. And finally, we are now graduates. So congratulations, guys. Somehow, we made it this far. But today is a day for self-reflection. What coming to York has given us, how we have changed, and how we will make change in the years to come. The world has become increasingly superficial, one that is focused on the pursuit of materials and the showcasing of their attainment. But remember, what glitters isn't always gold. For material may satisfy man's desires, it will not satisfy her soul. The unquantifiable, the immaterial, though, does, and that concerns the world's people, not its things. And though the world may measure success through that which is quantifiable, money, cars, jewelry, true wealth is determined by that which is unquantifiable, the things we do for one another, how we stand up with and for each other. Now, we must make the most of all opportunity that presents itself. But it is not only about what we are able to get out of an opportunity for ourselves. It is also about what we are able to do for others with the opportunity that we have been given. Because potential is accessible to all, where treasures of it lie within each and every one of us. But for some, opportunity is neither reachable nor is it present. Potential doesn't discriminate, but opportunity can do, and it often does. Why is it that if you are born in a certain location, or you look a certain way, or you have a certain name, a certain family, ethnicity, faith, culture, gender, or socioeconomic background, that you have less opportunity? Why? Why is this the case? This is the worst kind of condemnation, the condemnation from birth, the inequality of opportunity. And so, for those of us who have been so blessed to read and to learn, for those of us who have been so blessed to get ourselves to the point where we are able to accept a degree from this great university, for those of us sitting in this room here today, for those of us who are so fortunate, we have a great responsibility, a weighty responsibility. We don't just owe it to ourselves. We don't just owe it to our families and friends. We owe it to all those who didn't get the chance to be here. We owe it to them to reach our full potential, and we owe it to them to help realise ours, or realise theirs. This is not giving back, for we are not saviours. This is merely fulfilling our duty as human beings to one another. And in fulfilling this duty as nothing more than facilitators, we must be self-aware, empathetic, and always put others at the centre of their stories. Class of 2019, we are not just graduates. We are not just students. We must have immense self-belief for us to reach our own potential. We must be the game changers, the change makers, the system breakers. But no, we cannot wait till we make it. We must start now, today even, because if not now, then when? And if not us, then who? We don't have to travel to faraway lands to do this. Change starts with us. It starts with small, consistent decisions. It starts with ourselves, then to our home, to our friends, our neighbours, our community, and to communities around us, and so on. And as each day, hour, minute goes by, an injustice persists that brutalizes people, and there is one less person helping to solve it. So what are we going to do about it? Let's start by picking something, anything, an issue that we identify with, or an issue that someone close to us identifies with. And let's do the utmost we can to help that cause. But know that if we don't do anything, then our passiveness implicates us as an accomplice of the status quo. For inaction is also action, the action of ignoring, the action of looking away, the action of turning a blind eye. I stand before you today as the beneficiary of those who didn't turn a blind eye. For I am the product of social mobility and the child of two hardworking immigrant social workers, who, like many in this room, I am sure, have dedicated themselves to improving the lives of children across this country. And so, as no one is self-made, I'd like to take a moment to give some thanks. It's been a long road. First and foremost, above all things else, I would like to thank the Lord for giving me the chance to be here and allowing me to share this special moment with you all. Big up all my family, especially shout out to my mum, my dad, my little sister, and my baby bro. Big up all my bros, all my friends, mandem. Thank you to all my loved ones who I hope are resting peacefully. Thank you to all university staff and faculty for your support, the local community in York for being so kind to us, and all of you guys for making university so interesting. Though it is somewhat broken institutionally in its delivery, assessment, and content, education is powerful. Education is what took a chance on someone like me, someone who didn't meet the typical grade requirements to be here, but excelled anyway, and ended up studying at an Ivy League university for a year abroad. Education is what gave me the chance to bounce back from several severe injuries to representing the university football team. Education is what gave me a voice. Education is what has lifted my family out of poverty. Education is what lets an unruly, underachieving, underestimated kid stand before you today and deliver this address. But this is only the beginning for us. Class of 2019, today is our day. Celebrate it and relish it as we should. But as we leave our lovely colleges, the seamless 22, the glorious roses, and the aggressive geese of York behind, let's ask ourselves, what are we going to do with our moment, with our opportunity? How are we going to make our lives worth living? Because we have come too far. We have come too far to not do something. So as we dream big and continue the come up on our own journeys, let's bring up others with us and lead by example. For there is no time or place for pity. There is only time for action. And with that, class of 2019, congratulations once again. We made it. There's still much work to be done. But till next time, thank you for the honour and stay blessed. Thank you.
acting Vice-Chancellor and President. It is both a privilege and a pleasure to present to you our honorary graduate, Professor Dani Rodrik. Dani was born in Istanbul, completed his BA in Government and Economics at Harvard University, and his MA and PhD in Economics at Princeton University, and held economics professorial position since at Columbia, Princeton, and at Harvard, where he is based currently. Dani is one of those gifted social scientists who look at the same facts as everyone else, but see what nobody else has seen. So his outstanding research sits at the junction between economics and politics. So I will spend a few words outlining his unique contributions in understanding our societies, focusing on two main topics: the role of political institutions on economic development and globalization. Dani was among the first economists to identify in the quality of political institutions one of the fundamental determinants of economic development. The way political systems operate and the set of rules regulating social interactions profoundly shape the incentives of the economic agents interacting in the marketplace. For instance, the rule of law or the definition and enforcement of property rights foster investment, leading to economic growth. This is now commonly accepted in social science. But Dani's contribution in institutional economics goes further, warning against oversimplifications. Institutional features contributed to the economic success of one country may not be as successful elsewhere. We cannot simply copy-paste good institutions from well-functioning societies onto less successful ones. A certain degree of customization, blending in local knowledge, experience, and characteristics is needed to ensure successful institutional reforms. But let me now turn to Dani's extensive work on globalization. In 1997, amidst expanding world trade and enthusiastically cheering economists worldwide, Dani published his book, Has Globalization Gone Too Far?, in which he discusses the risk of hyperglobalization and examines the challenges the world economy faced in ensuring that the rapid international economic integration would not eventually contribute to the domestic social disintegration. The book focuses on three major sources of tension between globalization and social stability: the transformation of the employment relationship, conflicts between international trade and social norms, and the pressures that the ensuing concentration of resources and increasing inequality brought to bear on national governments in maintaining domestic cohesion and social welfare systems. Building on those initial reflections, he formalized in a very insightful 2000 article a simple theory known as Rodrik's trilemma, or the political trilemma of the world economy. According to his theory, liberal democracy, the form of democracy we are living in and that we rightfully treasure, national sovereignty and global economic integration are mutually incompatible. We can combine any two of the three, but never have all three simultaneously and in full. Therefore, assuming that we don't want to abandon democracy, the trilemma suggests that we cannot achieve full economic integration or globalization unless we seriously think about a political integration to be pursued alongside. That 2000 article turned out to be very helpful in understanding one of the most salient political trends recently: populism. The surge of the so-called populist movements across Europe, invariably and systematically blaming the European Union and its economic integration project for both social and economic domestic issues, is to be interpreted through the lens of this framework. Profound economic integration is incompatible with national sovereignty, and the political discourse of populist movements openly acknowledges this and proposes a solution to reverse economic integration to save national sovereignty. The only alternative for an integrated Europe, in the logic of the trilemma, is to give up national sovereignty in favor of a further political integration of Europe, a clearly less popular option in the European electorate, and perhaps therefore less openly endorsed by political parties. This brief and highly incomplete outline of Dani's work represents a compelling example for the academic community to actively engage with the policy world and with the wider public, as, using his own word, if we don't communicate our views, others will do it for us, and they will not necessarily do it as well, and they will have their own interests while they do it. He certainly set a high standard, regularly interacting with non-academic stakeholders, stressing the need for economists to engage with policy institutions and politicians to reframe the public understanding on how liberal democracy, sovereignty, and globalization work. His great and original thinking granted him several prestigious awards, like the appointment as elected fellow at the American Association for the Advancement of Science and the Albert Hirschman Prize conferred by the US Social Science Research Council, just to name a few. Acting Vice-Chancellor and President, at the current conjuncture with populist movements thriving across all developed nations and with globalization its consequences under scrutiny everywhere, the significance of Dani's work cannot be overestimated. And it is therefore with great pleasure that I present to you Professor Dani Rodrik for the degree of Doctor of the University honoris causa.
Thank you. And first of all, congratulations to all the graduates and their loved ones here. It's really a special privilege to be sharing this wonderful occasion with you. I don't know you each individually, obviously, but I know each one of you is special because of the hard work you have put in to get where you are. I should mention the support you have received from your parents and other loved ones who are also gathered here today. I was asked to say a few inspirational and aspirational words, but also be very short. The bit about being short is easy. Being aspirational, inspirational may be a little bit more difficult for an economist. It's not just the dismal nature of our discipline. It's also that, as economists, I think our advice has not been always, shall we say, problem-free. Many people hold us accountable for the financial crisis and, in fact, the trends in inequality and exclusion that have made the rise of authoritarian populism around the world an important topic of concern. In any case, I don't think I could possibly be do any better than the amazing and very moving oration that we have just heard. If I had to say a few words to you, I would start with one thing that I think has played an important role in my own career, and I think was mentioned by Giacomo in his introduction, is the importance of bucking conventional wisdom, that always be suspicious of conventional wisdom. By the time an idea becomes conventional wisdom, it's almost always definitely wrong, because all the details and the caveats and the exceptions have gone by the wayside. You have to question the truth that you are offered, but never give up the search for the truth. Try to be a skeptic, but not a cynic. Learn from history, respect tradition, but use these to expand your imagination and the horizons and the limits of what you are told are feasible and doable. Cherish wisdom, shun cleverness. is the first that's going to get you where you want to go and earn you the respect of your peers. Always seek a second opinion and never take what an economist says on any topics, including anything that I've covered, face value. So congratulations again, graduates, and may you make of your lives what you want them to be.
Vice-Chancellor, in the light of the wonderful oratory by Shahbaz Ahmad, I have the honour to present for the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Philosophy, Politics and Economics, Shahbaz Ahmad.
A minor omission. ladies and gentlemen, we're almost finished. First of all, I'd like to confer awards on all those graduates who elected to receive their awards in absentia. I'd like to offer my congratulations to Dani and to all of you. Very well done. I wonder if I can ask our guests, not the graduates, to stand. So, guests, please. So now is our last chance to congratulate this year's class, to wish them well, to sail them off into a very bright future and hope that they flourish in everything that they do. Please. So now, if I could ask the graduates to stand. So, as we movingly heard earlier, you've not made this journey on your own. You've been supported by university staff, academic staff, and support professional staff, your family, your friends who've nurtured you and looked after you and given you occasionally quite a lot of money. So now, now is your chance to say thank you to everyone who has supported you. Please. I now declare the congregation closed. Please remain standing.